What we have just seen is called a P-share predictor. It has a private history for each branch. That is, each branch should have its own history in the branch history table. And it has shared counters so that different histories and different branches might map to the same counters. This predictor is good for things like even-odd behavior, like taken, not taken, loops with few iterations, for example, those 8 iteration loops that we have seen, and so on. So pretty much whenever the branch's own previous behavior is predictive of its future behavior, P-share tends to do well. Another type of similar predictor that we can make is called G-share. It has a global history and shared counters. So a global history means that there is only a single global history that we use to predict all branches. So what we have is now the PC, a single history that we XOR together and index into the array of 2-bit counters. This history, every branch decision, regardless of what the PC of the branch is, gets shifted in here. So what is G-share good for? It's good for so-called correlated branches, that is, branches whose decision is related to what the other branches in the program were doing. Now I would think, when would that happen? And it turns out that it happens in programs quite often. Think about something like this. If my shape is a square, then do something. Then do something that you do either way, regardless of what the shape is. Then if the shape is not square, I have something else to do. This branch and this branch are entirely correlated. If this one was taken, this one will not be taken, and the other way around. So if this branch is in the history when this one is being predicted, then we can perfectly predict this branch. Note that, however, if we look at this branch individually, or this branch individually, the history of this branch might be completely random because it really depends on our data, whether shapes are squares. So if we randomly have shapes that are squares or not, we cannot really predict much here. So this branch might be mispredicted often because we simply don't know at that point. But this branch becomes perfectly predictable if it's using the history produced by this branch.